What's up, guys? Welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. My name is Pete, and today we're going to be talking about a controller to control aspects of your live stream that you can run on your mobile phone. So you won't need to alt tab back to the streaming software. You can do things like going live, switching scenes, enabling and disabling sources, or muting your mic right from your mobile phone. We're going to be covering it in detail and how to set it up in this video after a quick message from our sponsor. Nerd or Die have just dropped their latest stream pack called Interface, which has been designed in collaboration with Twaz. This cyberpunk-inspired stream package comes with overlays, alerts, event lists, chat box, stinger transitions, and profile panels. Check it out using the link below with code GAMINGCAREERS for 10% off at checkout. So this app is available both on iOS and Android. It's completely free, and as I said, it's built by Streamlabs. So the kind of things that it lets you do are things like going live, starting and stopping the recording, swapping scenes, enabling and disabling certain sources that are in those scenes, muting your audio, as well as changing your overall design if you wish to. I'm just going to give a quick demo as to how it works. So as you can see, I have Streamlabs OBS running on my computer. This is running on my phone. If I wanted to say change scene from my starting scene, which I'm on right now, to my intermission, I just click the button and it swaps scene. Now here you can see I have quite a lot going on. I've got quite a lot of different sources enabled on this scene. If I just wanted to disable my camera, I just click camera, my camera goes, click it again and it comes back. Super simple, instant in terms of how quickly it works. And it's a great little controller, absolutely free, that you can use on your live streams. So obviously the main advantage for this is that you never actually need to physically alt tab to Streamlabs OBS on your computer to be able to do these things. You can just do them from your phone, which could be on a little stand or it could just be next to your keyboard, and the screen stays awake throughout when you have the remote open, so you don't need to worry about unlocking your phone or something like that. It stays awake the whole time, so it's really quick and easy to use, and obviously the main advantage is that it's free. Now, one of the obvious comparisons people are going to be making between the app is with the Elgato Stream Deck, and I've got to say it's nowhere near as customizable as something like the Stream Deck is, as you would expect. The Stream Deck is a premium product. You can use it with a variety of different applications outside of streaming as well, things like editing programs. Completely customizable. You can change what each button does, how it looks. This is just the basics. So it just does Streamlabs OBS controls for different scenes, different sources, muting your mic. Like, I would call it the essentials, but obviously it's free, so you're not gonna get the same level of performance as you would out of a Stream Deck. But it's a really great alternative for those of you that maybe can't afford a Stream Deck or are saving up and just want to get your hands on a little controller right away. The other major thing to note is that the application only works with controlling Streamlabs OBS, not regular OBS Studio. So Streamlabs have built this application for your iPhone or for your Android devices, and it only controls Streamlabs OBS. So if you haven't yet tried out Streamlabs OBS, I have a link in the top of the description where you can download the software, and you'll need that for the next step, which is downloading and installing the app on your phone. So now you should have Streamlabs OBS installed on your computer. So if on your phone you head to the App Store or Play Store and search for Streamlabs, you should find the app that you need to download. On the App Store, it's called Streamlabs Stream Live. So click to download that, and I'll just give a brief description as to what the app does, because it does more than just the remote control feature. It's actually been built from the ground up to be an IRL streaming, so you can stream from your mobile phone and your mobile phone camera. So we're only going to be doing a small subset of that, as in we're going to be looking just at the remote control. So we're going to be skipping a lot of the functionality, but you might get some requests for permissions as we install the app to allow it to use the camera and microphone, because it's been built as an IRL streaming app. Once it's installed, you should be able to launch it, and you should be greeted with a login screen here. It's going to be in landscape because the whole app is built to be in landscape mode. You need to log in either with your Twitch or YouTube, Mixer, Facebook, whichever platform you're going to be streaming to and whichever platform is linked to your Streamlabs account. So for the majority of you and for me as well, that's Twitch. If I click login with Twitch, it's going to give me a form to log in, and as well as the authentication if you haven't already done that for Streamlabs. So just enter those details and I'll see you at the next screen. So again, when you launch it, you're probably going to see a screen that asks you to enable the camera and the microphone. This is if you wanted to use it for IRL streaming, so it's not necessary if you're just going to be using it for the remote control, but enable them if you are going to be thinking about doing any IRL streams. And then the next screen is going to ask you to enable some widgets for the IRL stream. Again, not necessary, so you can just click next and then finally get started. And it should take you to a screen which has a camera view. So you can see here's my Streamlabs OBS, and that's where I'm recording my videos. But we're actually interested in setting up the remote control. So if you hit the little hamburger in the top corner and then go to remote control, you can see it gives you a space to scan a QR code. Now in Streamlabs OBS on your computer, you want to come up here to the settings menu, down to remote control, and you can see here's a QR code. So line it up with your phone, click to show, and it should sync. And there you go. I have all the controls ready on my phone, and that will completely control Streamlabs OBS. So if I want to swap to my intermission scene, I just click it, and there is my intermission scene. If I want to hide my social media or my camera, it's as simple as that. Once it's set up, it's forever linked and it will stay on this screen. It won't dim down or lock your device as long as you have Streamlabs OBS open. A couple of things to note about the app is that it shows the sources depending on which scene you have selected. So right now I'm on my intermission scene and you can see I have quite a few different sources enabled. But if I just went to my stream starting soon scene, I only have the one source, which is just the video background that's looping. So it will always show the sources that are enabled and disabled in that scene. So if we go back to the intermission one, you can see it updates with all the different sources that exist inside that scene. One of the improvements I would love Streamlabs to make on the app is the ability to be able to rearrange the icons here, because these are set in a default order and you can't rearrange them. So what annoys me about this is this muting the mic or muting your desktop audio. Those are both options that are at the very, very bottom of the app, of the button list. I'd love to be able to move those up to the top, as those are really handy functions to be able to have right at your fingertips. You know, if you need to cough or if somebody comes into your room or something like that and you just want to mute your mic very, very quickly. One handy thing to think about is if you have an iPad or an Android tablet with a bigger screen than your phone, you can of course install this application on a tablet instead and you will have more buttons at your fingertips without needing to scroll around. So hopefully for those of you that are using Streamlabs OBS, you are now set up with your own little controller. I'm not by any means saying that this is a replacement for the Stream Deck. For me, the Stream Deck just has way, way more functionality and just so much easier to use. But I understand that it is out of some people's price point, and this is just a really simple way to get started with Streamlabs OBS and being able to up your production level by not having to alt-tab to your software and just control things from your phone instead. If you have enjoyed the video, please do give it a thumbs up. And if you are new to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, the whole channel is completely dedicated to helping you improve your live stream. So do look around at the other videos, and subscribers, make sure that you turn on the notification bell so you do not miss an upload. Finally, a massive thanks to my patrons this month. These people here help support the Gaming Careers YouTube channel by pledging money each month, which lets me do it full time and create more tutorials for you guys, the streaming community. So a massive thank you. And if you're interested in becoming a patron, please do check the link in the description. Subscribers, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.